There are four avenues in preservation. One of them is architectural history, one of them is planning, one of them is law and economics, and the fourth is conservation and technology. And my niche is the conservation and technology. I thoroughly enjoy the forensic side of being sort of in the middle. I'm not necessarily only doing history of the past, but I'm trying to say, how do we analyze this? How can we look at this? What happened? How can we avoid that in the future? And that is where I see BIM. It could be as something as simple as measure drawings. Other preservationists will say that it's all they use. It's almost like reading the building, and if you can't read it standing in front of it, you can read it through BIM. A drone will pick up millions, billions of points. In fact, when we did the grandstand, we had picked up the sand particles in the air. And so we actually had to recognize it and remove it before we could bring it into BIM as an object. And BIM allows us to create those drawings so that it meets the Park Service criteria and therefore can go to the Library of Congress. There's so many avenues that you can take that model. If you combine ARCHICAD with Rhino, Grasshopper, and there's others, you can really look at a community before you even touch it. You can set the time in the day and you can see the shadows, because that's another way of looking at landscaping. Where should you plant trees? Or thermal imaging, taking the radiant information that thermal imaging will give us and utilizing it to determine how many solar panels we need. My choice is probably going to be the right one, but if I want to be 100% comfortable, BIM helps make that happen. I am working with architecture faculty to make sure that they see the preservation side of it so that when they're utilizing it in a studio, I can either come in and be a guest lecturer, or just the fact that I said, have you thought of using it in preservation for a built building? It helps them see the possibilities of what a building can be and what it can become, where we can non-destructively look at the whole building. This is just amazing.